Welcome back to the Buckeye State Whales. We're back in Fauchery, Ohio. This is going to be a long day of whale fanning. I have a lot of footage of trains, so I hope you guys enjoy it. But anyway, here comes L-70 departing Fauchery to head west. This would be our first train at Fauchery. I would catch a gas train, but I didn't get a film. But anyway, this is L-70 with a pair of SD-40s that's going to be going out of Fauchery to go west. I think it goes out to Lima or something. I don't know where it goes, but I know it just goes west and it comes back at some point. So, yeah, it has a lot of oil. We got an eastbound that's going towards New York or Pennsylvania. Either way, it's going east on the Wheeler sub. It has the Gevo up front, and it would have a mid DPU. I don't know what's the DPU, but in this footage, I didn't really know. But it had a Mace as a mid DPU. Here comes the CSX northbound, but this one's a manifest. I'm guessing this one's heading towards Wallbridge, Ohio. It has a solo GE leading the manifest. Thank you. Here comes I-166. It's not CP, CP Casey, Jivo up front, which is leading the intermodal. It did some work in North Baltimore, and now it's heading east towards Buffalo, New York. Here comes an eastbound Athanol that's going east on the Willard subdivision, but it would only have CSX power. This shot is kind of cool. I don't usually get this shot, but it's just normal GEs of CSX, so I never got this shot before, so I may as well get this shot while I'm here. Here comes an eastbound on the Fosteria District. This one is 276, which is in Chicago to Norfolk, Virginia. It just has normal NS unit, but this is something we don't do every day. A train horn versus a wheel train. So that was pretty fun. So it was pretty funny as well. We'll be right back. That goes a westbound manifest. I don't know what the symbol is, but there it goes. But there goes all of my friends. Decided just to get a recording of them just being at the park.
It's a ghost train.
Well, there is. I don't know why those gates will be going off then. Besides, there is a westbound that's going by, so it's kind of weird. So. There is a coal train that is coming from the south, going west, taking the connection for west at Foss Joy.
Joe, there's a load of coal train.
It's loaded.
I'm president. No, Jeff, I am.
I know, you're... Yeah. I did this. Man, that building really blocks the view, doesn't it?
Yeah, I kind of wish they'd never build that.
Jeff, I'm the president of the sportsman.
Are you, really? Whoa. Congratulations.
Bah, get out of my...
But like you could tell, there is a westbound that is going slow, passing the crossing down there, but the same crossing that is like the east end of the park. There goes the gates, because this westbound would end up being a northbound, too. Be coming from the east, going north towards Wallbridge, so I don't know where this one's going. I'm guessing Wallbridge. It just has a solo Giro up front, and then I'm guessing there might be in the middle. Here comes B523. It has a 1-2 AC44CW and then a Jibo 1-3. But this one we did a little 2-2. I'll show you what I mean.
Ethan,
That clue did not even look at us. He was kind of like focusing where he was going. But I can kind of understand that. But it was kind of cool what we did. We did on the NS, and I think we were going to do it a lot more than we were when I was. There we go, here comes another train. This one says a grainer from the south. Now it's going north towards Saginaw, which will get Dragon White from Lake State Railway to go up to Saginaw. It was so cool to see a grain train, because I don't see grain trains on CSX as much as I used to. But it has one of the CM44 something. One of the rebuilds. I-151, clear, Fostoria. Well, it has to go kind of slow through here, because number one, it's going south, and it's also taking the connection to go west towards North Baltimore. Yeah, is this a Jivo leading? Thank you.
What?
Here comes a northbound on the Columbus subdivision, but soon as north of Fosgoia, it's going to be the Pudlerville. So I-132 goes north towards Woolwich to do some work before it goes to Detroit. There goes that westbound. Number 15, line 2, is trailing. That's a manifest. And now we have another northbound Arawak that's taking the connection from the east to go north. And it has a line 3-8, trailing second of this Arawak train.
all see as far as they are. Most of the Spartan cats are decided to either scratch the cats on.
I'm just sad about the yellow cats.
Well, I mean, to be fair, their ex-Santa Fe beat everything they owned to the ground. So, I mean, even the
story behind the ACU.
I saw an ACU on that. I saw an ACU going through off the Chicago line.
It's finally a Norfolk Southern on the Foss Joya District. Yay! Just a G-Row up front, and then an AC-44C6M as a mid-DPU of this train. I'm guessing this is 302, bound for Bellevue, Ohio. But I could be wrong. Now I'm close to Poplar Street, but here comes a westbound intermodal that's going west towards North Baltimore or Bedford Park, Illinois. Here comes an eastbound / northbound that's going to take the Y to go north towards Walbridge, because this is 506 from Cincinnati, Ohio to Walbridge, Ohio. I don't know why it just doesn't go straight north towards Deschler. I don't know why it just doesn't go straight north through there. But still, it's still another train with a G-Lo on it.
Making that connection.
Thank you. where?
Those are Chicago and Northwestern. I can tell. Man, my ears are on.
That's probably what the dog's probably whining.
That's probably the reason why. Wow. Hey, sir! Nope, no. Here comes L-70 returning east from wherever it works at towards Fosteria now. This is just like cool because I like these trees when it comes to spring. And by the time I'm editing this video, it's almost the summer. So, yeah, that's just gonna be interesting, because now here comes L-70, returning back to Fosteria after it went west, like, hours later. 3493 does not even lead, but it's still cool. SD-40s. Well, this is 303, Solo Dash 9, which is going straight west. It was going fast. I was just at the building by the restrooms and the caboose. And I went from there to these trees way over where I'm filming at. Whew! Trust me, I went quick as I can. But the photo is really good. I'll show it to you right now. Here comes an eastbounder on the Norfolk Southern Falls Joya District. This one has a UP leader and the whaler that we would not see anymore. I'll explain it right now. So basically, I was explaining here, Kansas City Southern that we do not see anymore. It's not a national railroad anymore. CP Casey is now the new railroad with CP and Kansas City Southern. It's just CP and Casey. I don't know anymore. Just choose a name and let's go with it. I don't really care. It's just cool to see Kansas City Southern now, because it's like with the merger, and there's not going to be as much CP. There's going to be a lot of Kansas City Southern and some CP. They're going to be like in a mix of the trains of all CP and whatever that interchange is with CSX and whatever railroad. But it's still cool. Don't get me wrong, it's still pretty cool to see. I would say this shot was actually pretty good. I'm kind of glad I did this shot. You know why? It's because there was like a rainbow and I pretty got a good shot of my camcorder. Was it even near the rainbow? But I did get a clip of it on my phone. Here it is right now after this clip on the camcorder. There's no more rainbow! But, we would say I do have another special one that's coming. I-165, which is usually with CP, but it's now CP Casey. But I bet you can tell, there's a gray unit. What is that? If you didn't think. But, it's an X-City Whale trailing I-165. I heard about it like earlier today. Here comes IO-16, going eastbound through Falls Joy, Ohio, on a Gary Wheeler. But this wet hour is just starting. So this will be the first train, or second train. IO-65 was the first one, and now this is the second one of this wet hour so far. It's just starting, like I said earlier. But we're probably gonna get a lot more trains than this so far.
Hey, boss, that could be Gamer Pad! David!
Thank you.
This would be unusual, IUCC. Well, it will then. One hopper and an engine behind the hopper is doing some long hood forward. What the heck? This is never normal. But I guess they were just doing some entropy switching. Well, folks, we're still well fitting around Fostoria. We're still hanging it there. And by the way, we have IO-17-09 that has a Geo up front, but the sunset is about to come. I gotten some pretty good pictures. I would say, though, the sun is going down, and by the time the sun's going down, we're going to lose light. So I don't have any of my lights with me, so that's going to be an issue. Well, the same engine that is coming back east after they were dropping that one hopper off, a single engine is going back east to the Fostoria yard. I don't know what the name is of Fostoria, of the yard in Fostoria on the CSX, but I just don't care what the name is. I'm just gonna call it Fostoria yard. Anyway, we have an eastbound NS. This would be the last NS of the day. This is a really cool clouds that I got of the shot. It has a BNSF leading. Solo and then one in the weird DPU of this train. Alright, I don't know what type of manifest this is. I'm guessing this is M201 from Woolbridge, Ohio to Chicago and Illinois, which is Bar Yard in Chicago. It's just Jeebos. What the heck is that foamer doing in the background? But anyway, this one's taking a while to go west, and then from there to go to Chicago.
Thank you.
Here comes another intermodal. This will be the last westbound of the day. We would have one more train before I would leave to go back home. However, what is that idiot doing that's going over the tracks around the gates? Anyway, this is a westbound intermodal bound for Bedford Park, Illinois. Seems all intermodals go to Bedford Park. I don't know why, but they do. Just Biggie. It's just GMOs. GEs. That's what it is.
Thank you.
Wow, our last train of the day. Yay. It's about to be dark. This is the only light that I can get without being dark and getting a bad shot. Anyway, this is the last train for the day. B-522 from Middletown, Ohio to Detroit, Michigan. He will be taking a ride to go north to Warwick, Toledo, and then Detroit. So, it's just GE's that's leading. I don't know why, it's always GE's. Oh! 7272. Flesh.
I'm gonna take you by the north.
Well, this was a really, really good time in Fosteria. Now it's getting ready to be dark. It was during the day when we made it to Fosteria to start the whale finning day. But now it's starting to be dark, which would mean we will have to end the day here and end my video here in Fosteria, Ohio. At this time, this video will be ending off here. Thanks for watching. I will be seeing ya maybe in a Michigan or state, but I most likely will see you in a Buckeye State Wells.